Assalamu alaikum, bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Ladies and gentlemen, let's continue our tutorials about hourly analysis program HAB. In this video, I'm going to show you how to input the general information about your project. Okay. Here is the mole. And this is the weather we have set it in the last video from Middle East, Egypt, Cairo, and the design temperatures and design solar and the simulation. Okay, now this is the project and properties. This is the information. Okay, and here is the view and preferences, metric or English, and the standard. It's very important to check out the standard from ASHRAE standard 62.1 2007. If you run the or if you use HAB 4.9, you will find ASHRAE 2007 and 2009. And 10, okay, or you make it user defined. So if you use 2007, no problem. Okay, now we are gonna to define the general information in the spaces. The spaces is the zones, or the zone that is required to install the HVAC system for it. Okay, here is the there are many tabs here, the general, internals, walls, windows, doors, roofs, skylights, infiltration, floors, partitions. Okay, the name here is the name of the zone you wanna make or calculate the cooling loads for it. Okay, it may be an office, it may be whatever you want. Okay, HAB is recommended to use this code for the name of the zone. Actually, we have here project. Okay, here is our zone. It is this is a room. Okay, it's 5 meters and 5 meters, and with height 3 meters. And the thickness is 203.3 millimeters. Okay, it's brick. Okay, and here we can see the north and east. Okay, this is the north, west, south, and east. Okay. Okay, this is the orientations. Okay, this is a required zone. Okay, here we go. Okay, this is the name, the default space. We can see that yeah, if this zone is one of many zones in your building and it is in the ground floor. Okay, you can make it here as 001. This is the first zone in the ground floor, okay, with the name of office. This is the first office in the ground floor, okay, or whatever you want. It's not an office, it is a computer lab. It's computer lab. Doesn't matter, but type what you wanna type. Make it an office. If this zone is in the first floor, you can make it here first, or the second floor, or the third. Okay, here the ground floor. The area, the floor area, actually is the floor area here, is 5 meters times 5 meters, 25 square meter. Okay. Okay. Square meter, and the average ceiling height, if you have if this zone have a suspended ceiling, the average ceiling height is the distance from the floor to the suspended ceiling. If you don't have suspending ceiling, so the distance is the all 3 meters. If you have a suspended ceiling to 1 meter from here, so the average ceiling, I think it is 2 meters, not the all 3 meters. Okay, if you have many suspended ceiling with many heights, you can take the average. Okay, from the floor to one to the second to the third, and take the average. Okay, here is, we have don't have a spinning ceiling, so it make it 3 meters. The building weight actually is very important to be determined. We have many choices here. It is in kilogram per square meter. Here is our brick. The height, the weight of the building, every mass in the building should be included here, or this zone, this particular zone. Light, you can make it light or medium. Please notice this, it's 146.5 kilogram per square meter. And the med, here the med, 346.7, and the heavy is 603.34.7. Okay, and how does this affect? Okay, if our building or the zone, you wanna install the HVAC system in it, consists of many glasses and many glass windows. I mean it. Okay, you can make it light. And this determines the amount of heat storage in the building. If your building of real zone is light, it takes a short time to store the solar heat. Okay, and then it will transfer this heat into the inside zone. And if your building or your zone is heavy in the construction, the storage time will increase, and you may have 3 hours until all the heat is transferred into your zone from inside to the inside zone. And if it is light, if it's light, it takes 2 hours, not 3 or 4 hours. Okay, So, if your building or your zone consists of many glass windows, make it light. Or you, my recommendation here is to ask the architecture engineer, because he is the most accurate, informative in this case. Okay, if your building consists of two windows with glasses, okay, you can make it between light and medium. Okay, and if your building only have one window with one glass, glass windows, okay, you can make it heavy, and this will increase the storage, the time of the heat storage, and will decrease the cooling load. Okay, actually you should be sure about this value, because it is very important. And here is the OA ventilation requirements. The ventilation is the amount of ventilation that required for this particular zone. You can use it, you can input it by yourself, user defined, or you can select it from the standard here. This is an office, so you'll find here office and reception area or office space. This is our an office space. This is according to the standard 62.1 2007, or you can make it by yourself. Here is the 62.1 2010. Here you can find the recommended. Here is the minimum ventilation rates in breathing zone for beauty and nail salons, pet shops. Here is the amount people outdoor air rate, CFP per person or liter per second per person, and the area outdoor air rate is CFM per foot square foot or liter per second meter square meter. Okay, you can use these values or from the standard to ASHRAE 2013. And input it by yourself, as in here as user defined. Okay, you can make it 2.5 liter per second per person for the office. Okay, here you can find many zones for kitchen or coffee stations. Okay, and here is the office space. The office space is 2.5 liter per second per person. It's people outdoor air rate. Okay, this is 2.5. Okay, yeah, it is not different from this standard, 2.5, and we can here make it as a total ventilation in liter per second for the total. It's a total, not per person or per square meter, or you can make it as a percentage of the total supply air from the machine. Okay, I recommend use it as liter per second per person. Okay, like here it's very simple. Okay, liter per second 2.5, and here the requirement too is liter per second Okay. Okay, here is the there are two values. The first value is 2.5 per liter per second per person. This is the ventilation for persons, and the second ventilation rate is the ventilation for the area of this zone. Okay. Okay, here is 2.5 and liter per second and 0.6, not 0.3. So these are the difference. Okay. Actually, the building weight also it is required, and it is very important to and this average ceiling height should be accurate for the infiltration to calculate the volume of your zone, and it will be very benefit for infiltration calculations to calculate or to determine the amount of infiltration air that required or this infiltration required to be set here. Okay, and we are going to talk about the infiltration in the next couple of videos. Thank you very much.